So I'm super excited to hear that we're going to learn the backstory of the hat. Have you known it all along?
Yeah, I read the script. But I didn't know.
From season one.
No.
They told you?
They always told me that this. No, they never told me why Louise always wears her ears. And they said that's something that they're kind of saving in their back pocket for a very big occasion. And this. I don't know how much
how
to give away.
How were you able to play the character without knowing all that the full backstory? That's really impressive.
Yeah. We didn't. I think there's stuff that they had imagined in the conception, but that we aren't told until it's time to reveal it.
Yeah.
So if your character,
and also, I don't think they knew then either.
Oh, really?
So
it's just
Dan,
like it was there, and then that's
I had
it.
Created that she had some sort of, special horns that she didn't want anyone to know about because then the scientists would take her away.
That's a whole different show.
Yeah. That's the Mutter Museum.
That's a good show. Yeah,
saving for the
or the next movie. It could be the sequel, the movie sequel.
So the guy who shat so much that his bowel was like, did you see that part?
Sorry, we are now on to the Mutter Museum in Philadelphia because they have a lot of jars with people with horns and stuff.
Yeah, real ones.
So that ties in.
Yes.
Yeah, that's yes. So we're not crazy. We're just drifting.
It happens at WonderCon. Definitely. If your characters were writing the movie, what would it be about?
Tina's would obviously be her erotic friend fiction.
The whole movie.
I'm sure. Well, it would probably, I guess if she had one movie to make, you'd kind of compile like little bits and pieces, mm-hmm. like kind of a greatest hits thing, you know? You have to make sure it's all consistent,
but yeah.
Yeah, Louise would probably make the movie about probably destroying the Earth, with an alien invasion, and she's the only one who can save it.
Jean would try to probably work with her, but make it a rock opera.
And who would direct?
Yeah. Who would direct?
Yeah.
I don't know, someone
not
who probably
Jean.
Wasn't. No, not a child.
Louise, there's an episode where Louise directs.
Yeah.
Meat Man. And I think she does a dang good job.
Good.
Yeah.
Now, of all the music that's been in the series, do you guys have a favorite song?
I like the Topsy song a lot. That's always kind of stuck with me.
That's a good one. I mean, Bad Stuff Happens in the Bathroom is one that I recently read a fan said they sing it when they're having a bad day to get them going, and I thought that makes it a hit for me too then.
You know, there's a cover of Alone that Gene sings that I always enjoyed. Also Topsy and that stuff. And then I can't remember.
Well, there's some songs in the movie.
Oh, yeah.
The
opening song
bangers,
that they played.
Bangers,
yeah, that like the sunny side up
summer.
It's a big hit.
It's a hit.
Awesome.
With me.
It's going to tie with Bruno on the charts.